Hey, I'm Keith Urban, and you're on Musichead. I think the internet's a great place to be able to really forge a more one-on-one relationship with us and our audience. And I think, especially in this day and age when there's so many avenues for information that are not really accurate, that it's nice to actually have a place where you can get some clear, concise, informative information on what's going on. We're sort of a bit inundated with people wanting to talk about what I'd gone through, and I didn't want to go about it in a sensationalized fashion, because that's not what it's not why I went through what I went through. And so the forum was really a place for us to clear the air. Nashville's a great place to spend a lot of time if you're going to spend, you know, 3, 4, 5 months making a record. It's a good place to be. I think the studios are great. There's a ton of them. The session players are phenomenal. I think the engineers are great. I don't even know if there's a Nashville sound. I think there's just there's an environment that is attractive to people coming there. But I don't know. I mean, you know, Kings of Leon recorded their record there, and I don't think I'd compare them to, you know, Tim McGraw recording his album there either. But it's all Nashville. There's a healthy competitiveness in any industry where you've got charts and there's only like room for one number one, and you know, and that's kind of the way it is. But I found Nashville to have a good camaraderie. And you know, artists playing on each other's records and touring with each other, and most everybody speaking pretty well of each other. So that part of the community I've been really appreciative of. The writing community too, which is where I moved into straight off the bat, you know, when I got there. That's a really cool community, hanging out with all the songwriters and going to the songwriters' nights, and just that was really educational for me, and I got to meet a lot of good people. Close my eyes and I see you standing right there, saying I do, and you're throwing the rice in our hair. You're the first ones born, and a brother comes along, and he's got your smile. I've been looking back on the life we had, still by your side, so don't fear. Bono says his favourite songs are either about, you know, running to God or running from God. And I think from a love, spiritual, God, all standpoint, that's a pretty accurate way to put it. People are either talking about losing love or finding it. And I could spend a long time messing around with them, but in the end, that's really the purest form. So I did a lot of leaving things alone this time. And that's funny, because sometimes at those moments you go, oh, maybe I was a bit lazy, and you keep wanting to mess with them. They came because that's what they were meant to be. They're nothing more, nothing less than that. There's some mischievous ones in there, which is good. Always got to have them around for a good laugh. I easily could have spent more time on this record, but that's every record. You know, I think Sting said that you never finish an album, you just give up. It's pretty accurate. I try not to think too much about that, because it doesn't do any good, and I try to just keep it like it's the first record, like just going in and making music I really love and trying to capture it, what I hear in my head, you know. It's like I can audialize things as opposed to visualize it, I audialize it, and trying to get that to come to fruition is sometimes impossible. It's very frustrating, but I think a lot of times art is in the attempt, you know. That's why there's so much frustration involved. It's like I'm trying to create this, and this is what I ended up with, and everyone goes, oh, I love that. You go, but I wasn't, you know. So we're sort of on to the next thing, and here's the record here. So we'll be right back. country's funny because it always cycles around. It goes through phases of whatever's popular at the time and incorporates a lot of that, you know. Certainly in the 80s with Urban Cowboy, it embraced a lot of cosmopolitan soft rock and, you know. And then there's always a resurgence in traditional to sort of bring the pendulum back to the core of the genre. And then it swings out again with an artist or a few artists that sort of take it somewhere. So I don't know where it's going, but that's what I love about country. It's free flowing and it's always been open, I think, to evolution. Yeah, it's been an interesting year. I've learned a lot about not getting caught up in all that stuff, you know, not reading all that stuff, and keeping a good, clear communication with my family and my wife, you know, and just getting on with my life, because everybody's got hearsay, speculation, rumors, this, that, you know. And you can take a picture and it can say so many different things depending on what's written underneath the picture. But the bottom line is, it's 9 times out of 10, it's got actually no relevance to my real life and what's actually really going on. And so my wife and I know exactly what's going on. My family knows what's going on. I know what's going on. And I just get on with it. Let everything else be tomorrow's fish wrapping.
Well, she was precious like a flower. As she grew wild, wild but innocent. A perfect prayer in a desperate hour.